Well, we've heard what the reviewers think. You talk us through it. How do you think it went from your end? It's one gig with the Oils. It's short notice, sure. You got one hand tied behind your back, but I would have thought you'd pull it off, Paul.
Mate, I just barely hung on by the skin of my teeth.
Right.
I had Pete in my face, inches away, going, yeah, West Forces! And I was just going, geez, man, I didn't remember the chorus. They had one song, they come up, little powwow before every song, come up to Hesse. Okay, Hesse, this one's a flow, this one's a slow, this one's got to stop in the chorus, it's got to stop in the chorus. Yeah, it's like funky. No, it's like Motown, slow, easy, just take it easy. This one's an easy one, take it easy. And then they counted in. 1, 2, 3, 4! I'm thinking, Jesus, man. I can't wait for the fast one, you know. And then they leave that at the very end of the night. The fastest one, they do that one, I don't want to be the one. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm with you. Get me out of here, Hirsty, get back. And the very end of the song's just got Garrett just standing on the riser going, wah! For about 6 bars. And you're supposed to play the drum fill all the way through it.
Oh, and you're there with a pair of brushes going, when do these come in?
Blood was coming off the hands. I was just tapping aimlessly at the tom-toms. I think I hit something like a microphone and I think it just sounded a bit out the front and people just generally went with it and thought, oh, well, you see, that's a jazz thing, obviously.
He's improvising. Well, it's some of the best instinctive drumming ever seen, according to the advertiser, and you got presented with a bunch of flowers at the end of the show.
I did, and I got asked to go to Peter's room after the show at the hotel for a cup of tea.
Oh, that doesn't often happen.
You're in.
I was in
the inner circle.
In Peter's room. With the Oils, young Martin, young Jim, young Bones, Peter and myself. Cup of teas all around, chocky biscuits, beautiful. Mm. They get into this argument, full-on argument. I'm sitting there going, oh, I've walked into one here. I got bloody young Martin and young Jim over here arguing for the Spice Girls. And I've got Peter Garrett on the big double bed with all the pillows fluffed up around him arguing for Hanson. And it's on. It's on. The Oils are losing it. They're screaming. Furniture's going everywhere. Garrett's like, out! Out! My girls love Hanson because they're a real band. This is something you guys have to know about. Spice Girls crap. Yeah. And then Martin and Jim are down the hallway yelling back spicings, you know.
Well, meanwhile, you're sticking up for the Wiggles. The Wiggles, I tell you.
I was.
Know why Peter Garrett because is better about it because wannabe is just wannabe the one.
That's it.
Slow down a bit.
They've ripped him off.
All right.
He doesn't like their hair. That's his problem with Hanson.
I tell you what, he's sporting a moustache at the moment. Which is very sexy. Yeah, if you get along to your Oils gig, I think you're going to get a little bit more sexual sex than you thought you would have in the past. Sure, in the past, they're sten-gunning, they're stampeding their way towards it. But now, they're introducing a few simple kisses in the set and being lovely. And Pete Sarong falls off the hips. It's got a little Sonia McMahon thing going at the side. I think when he sten-gun jumped off the start of US Forces, I copped a little bit of a look in there and saw the lime green undies of Pete Garrett. And then I saw him after the show all changed. They all went nude. They all take their gear off, throw it in a bag.
Right.
Woman takes it away. Very strange.